Hello friends, hope you're all doing great. So here I come with newspaper analysis specially on Karnataka related news. So that is for the 20th November 2018. So in this I'm going to condense the news from The Hindu and Deccan Herald also. So if you have any doubts regarding KPSC exams, so please click on to the website, that is KS Moksha, or else you can call up or you can WhatsApp to the number which is present on the screen. So if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, so please do subscribe and click on the bell icon. So if you like these videos, please like the video, click on the like button, and also you can share with your friends. So let's begin. So here we see Chitradurga gets Passport Seva Kendra. So here we see that Passport Seva Kendra will be functioning at the head post office in Chitradurga. So when it is getting a function, that is when it is starting functioning, is from the first week of January, that is 2019. So a new Passport Seva Kendra will be in Chitradurga. So next we see UAS, that is University of Agriculture Science, Dharwad, to host Sahitya Sammelan. So 84th All India Kannada Sahitya Sammelan will be held at University of Agriculture Science, Dharwad, and this was formally announced at a meeting of stakeholders by Kannada Sahitya Parishad President Manu Baligar. So he has formally announced this, that 84th All India Kannada Sahitya Sammelan will be held at University of Agriculture Science. So let us see the background of Kannada Sahitya Sammelan. So Kannada Sahitya Sammelan, Kannada Literature Conference we call it. So this is a premier gathering of the writers, poets and Kannadigas. So why it has been established? So this is to preserve and develop the Kannada language and its literature, art and Kannada culture, and also the Kannada music. So to preserve the language, its art, its culture and its music, so this particular conference have been organized. So next we see that when it was started, so it was started in 1915 by H.B. Nanjundaya, and it was held for the first time at Bangalore. So initially, the prominent writers and poets used to inaugurate this particular conference from 1915 to 1948. But then later, that is after 1948, we could see that this conference will be inaugurated by Chief Minister of Karnataka every year. And the responsibility for holding this conference gathering rests in the hands of Kannada Sahitya Parishad. So Kannada Sahitya Parishad is responsible for holding the gathering at Kannada Sahitya Sammelana. So this is all about Kannada Sahitya Sammelana. 84th conference will be going to held at University of Agriculture Science, Dharwad. So next we see the Hindu Science Fest in Hubballi on Thursday. So this is the event that is going to be organized by The Hindu, that is a newspaper group, so the Hindu group of publications. So where here this The Hindu Science Fest is focused on developing the innovative cost-effective working models under the concept of Make in India. So this is to focus on innovative cost-effective working models under the concept of Make in India. So this is all about The Hindu Science Fest, which is going to be organized by the Hindu group of publications in Hubballi on Thursday. So next we see Achievers honored with Karnataka Bhushan Award. So in recognition of the outstanding contribution to society, seven artists. So that means Karnataka Bhushan Award is presented to honor the artist or the contribution in the field of art. So by who gives this award? By Hoti Foundation. So this Hoti Foundation gives the award. So who are the seven artists who were honored with this Karnataka Bhushan Award? So they were painter Basavaraj Gavimath from Ilkal, folk singer Baburao Kobal from Kalburgi, photographer Ayozuddin Patel from Kalburgi, theatre artist Raghunath Banigal from Vijayapura, playback singer Ramesh Joshi from Kalburgi, and writer Raghu Shankar Bhatabra from Bidar, and writer Guru Prasad Vaidya. So these are the seven people who were honored with this Karnataka Bhushan Award, where everyone, all of them belongs to North Karnataka. And this was given by Hoti Foundation. So next we see changes in Lokayukta Act. So the state cabinet has decided to bring in an amendment to Lokayukta Act which would empower the Lokayukta to delegate powers to Upalokayukta. So here what happens? Lokayukta would delegate the powers to Upalokayukta if a probe was ordered against Lokayukta himself. So if there is a probe ordered against Lokayukta, then that power goes to Upalokayukta. So here at present the act is silent on the issue of delegation of powers to Upalokayukta in such a situation. So here let's see some of the background regarding Karnataka Lokayukta. So Karnataka Lokayukta is nothing but an ombudsman institution of Indian state of Karnataka, and this was established in 1984 on the report on corruption in government of Karnataka and to redress the public grievance related to state government employees. So here we see how this Lokayukta is appointed. So this Lokayukta is appointed by Governor of Karnataka on the advice of Chief Minister of Karnataka in a consultation with Chief Justice of High Court of Karnataka, the Chairman of Karnataka Legislative Council, the Speaker of Karnataka Legislative Assembly, and the Leader of Opposition in Karnataka Legislative Council, and the Leader of Opposition in Karnataka Legislative Assembly. So here this is how Lokayukta is appointed, and Lokayukta has a power to investigate the cases in relation to the Chief Minister, all the other ministers and the members of state legislature and all the state government employees. So next we see two from Bengaluru wins Hellen Keller Award. So here we see two from the city have been named for National Center for Promotion of Employment for Disabled Persons, Mindtree Hellen Keller Award. So this is for the promotion of employment for disabled persons, that is by Mindtree Hellen Keller Award. So who bagged this award? So both are from Bengaluru. So one is Moses Chowdhury Gorapatti, who was a program manager, works in Enable India. And one more person is Naveen Ravindranathan, Executive Issue Retrieval Center, IT Asset Management, Dell EMC. So both will be receiving the award on December 2nd in New Delhi. So next we see its status quo on KPSC's recruitment quota norms. So here we see, so there was an issue going with the KPSC recruitment quota norms. So here we see the meritorious candidates from reserve category can be appointed under general merit category, and the state cabinet had decided to maintain the status quo with regards to reservation in direct recruitment by Karnataka Public Service Commission. So here, briefing the press persons on the decision taken by state cabinet, Law and Parliamentary Affairs Minister Krishna Bairegowda said a decision was taken to continue the earlier policy which allowed the meritorious candidates from reserved category to be appointed under general merit category. So here, meritorious candidates from the reserved category can be also appointed under general merit category. So next we see e-swathu and e-khata facilities to come to the doorsteps of beneficiaries. So these both facilities have been implemented in Udupi district's administration. So where e-swathu documents will be given by Gram Panchayat and e-khata will be given by urban local bodies. So here it is, these two programs or these two facilities are to get the beneficiary documents, so necessary documents, so without approaching any of the offices which are concerned, and to reduce the inconvenience of the people to get any of the documents that is from the government. So that is what we see, e-swathu and e-khata facilities were provided by the Udupi district administration. So here the advantage with the new system is that beneficiary will receive documents within 45 days, and the documents will be helpful for the beneficiary to avail loan and other facilities which is produced along with the Aadhaar card. So when it comes e-swathu and e-khata facilities, that is by Udupi district administration to get the doorstep, to get the facilities to the doorstep of the beneficiaries. So this is all about the Karnataka current affairs related, Karnataka related news of as of today, that is 20th November, that is from Hindu and the Deccan Herald. So hope you all understood it. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day.